Hey guys, what I'm going to do now is figure out a way for the robot to use the light sensor, which I have now attached to the front of the robot. So this is the light sensor here. And I want to now figure out a way for the robot to keep following the line by using the light sensor. So it's going to follow the line and drive around the square like that. Okay, so keep going around the square. Anyway, so how do I make that happen? Well, firstly, let's turn on the robot, right? And let's go to, so you will see four tabs on the top, and we want to go to the third tab from the left, and we want to go to port view. So click on port view, and you will see here my light sensor is attached to the third port. Right, port number 3, it's attached to the light sensor at the front. So I'm going to go to port 3. So that's port 3. And then you can see right now it's got a reading of 0. But if I go into it and I go into color reflect, okay, then I can sit the robot down in front of the blue, and you can see here it's got a reading of 3. Okay, on the blue color, it's got a reading of 3 or 2 or at most 4 for the blue. And then if I sit the robot on the what color do you call this? Brown color. It's giving me a reading of 18. Okay, so these are the two colors that we need. 3 and 18. So the algorithm that we're going to use is we're going to get the number 3 and the number 18, add them together, divided by 2. So that is 21 divided by 2, which is 10.5. So I want to program the robot so that if the light sensor reads a number bigger than 10.5, then it's going to move to the left. But if it reads a number smaller than 10.5, then it's going to move to the right. So basically, it's going to continue moving left and right depending on what the color sensor reads. Right, because obviously if it's touching the blue, it'll get a reading less than 10.5, so it will move to the right. And then when it's on the yellow, it'll get a reading bigger than 10.5, so it's going to move to the left. And then it will just keep circulating around the square. So let's see what happens. So now we're going to take you guys through the programming of this line following robot. So the first block we want to drag to the program is under the flow control panel, and we're going to drag into the program the looping block. And what this does is it loops whatever is inside our program over and over again so that it keeps doing it forever, which is what we want. We want our robot to follow the line forever. Unless we turn the program off, then it stops. The next thing we want to do is we're going to drag on another flow control block called the switch. So what the switch does is it evaluates a certain condition. Okay, it evaluates a certain condition and see whether it's true or not. And if it is true, then we will do whatever we put inside the top section. If it's false, we will do whatever we put inside the bottom section. So what are we going to evaluate the condition for? We're going to see whether the light sensor or the color sensor, we're going to compare the value that is measured by the color sensor. And what are we measuring? We're measuring the reflected light intensity. Okay, which is what we use to test the values of the blue and the brown just before. So what we're going to test is see whether the measured value is bigger, is greater than 10.5. This 10.5 represents halfway between the blue color and the brown color. So whenever the robot measures a color bigger than 10.5, that would mean that it's on the brown side. Okay, if it's detecting brown, then we want the robot to move to the left. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag up the move tank block. And I like the move tank block because it allows you to control the power level of each motor individually. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the power level of the right hand side motor to 100 and the power level of the left hand side motor to negative 20. Okay, the reason for that is because if the right hand side motor is moving forward at a power of 100 and the left hand side motor is moving backwards at a power level of 20, a negative means it's moving back, then the robot will be turning to the left. Okay, now I'm simply going to copy this and paste it in the bottom section. So Control C for copy, Control V for paste. Actually, why is this? I'm gonna make it come out further a bit. What this will do is it's gonna reverse it. So I'm gonna make the left hand side motor 100 and the right hand side motor negative 20, so that if the color detected is not bigger than 10.5, in other words, it's equal or smaller than 10.5, then we're going to make it turn to the right, right? Because the right hand side motor is going back and the left hand side motor is going forward, so it's going to turn to the right. Okay, and the last thing I want to do is, instead of specifying a number of rotations, I'm just going to turn it on, just set it to on. So basically, it's going to keep doing it forever until, just resizing it to make this better. So it's going to keep doing this forever until the light value switches to the other side. Okay, so let's test out this program. So let's download it to your robot now. So make sure you save it first, save the project, and then if you download this program, okay, so you can hear the sound, it means it's downloaded, and let's go and test it out. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.